most country clubs in the United States are going broke or going under right now. Most, not all of them, but a good share of them are. The government is unworkable the way they are right now. The middle class is on the way out, no doubt about that.
You know, Shawnee had its own personality, didn't it?
He'd been the bartender there at Shawnee for, I don't know, 25, 30 years. And he had a nice family. He had a boy that was in a wheelchair. And he was a great guy, though, really was. He asked me one time, he said, "Who's cutting your grass?" And I said, "I am, and I don't like it." And he said, "My boy, I got a son that can cut the grass. He'd do a good job." And I said, "Okay." So Earthel brought him over to my place. I lived in Prospect Hills out there. And right around the corner from I don't remember who, the guy that ran for president, remember? What's the guy's name? Oh, Alf Landon. Alf Landon, yeah, right around the corner from him. Yeah. Anyway, Earthel brought his son out there, and he'd stay in the car or in the shade while the kid was working. The kid would spend about 2 hours there. Yeah. And one time, the kid didn't show up, and Earthel came. And it's hotter than hell. It was right in the middle of, like, August or something. And Earthel Grant comes out up there, and I said, "What are you doing here?" And he said, "Well, the boy," he said, he went somewhere and he didn't come home. So I come out and I'm cutting the grass. And I said, "Well, you don't need to do that." And I said, "You know, it's too hot out there. An old fart like you," I said, you know, "you'd liable to die out there." And I said, "I know I wouldn't do it this hot." And he said, "Well, I'm going to do it because I told you I'd get somebody to do it. And if he can't do it, I will." So he did. You know, what a good guy, though. I remember back in, I think it was 69. Yeah, it was 69. Cardinals were playing in the World Series. And I had, I got, the Cardinals sent me four season, World Series tickets to St. Louis. Just to the home games. They played four games in St. Louis and three on the road. And he was crazy about St. Louis. Anyway, I went to the first game. And the second game, I think I stayed up there. And then I came back and I gave that tickets, four tickets to Urthel Grant. And he said, my God, he said, I think I died and gone to heaven. And he and his wife and kids went up there and went to the game. We took them to the game, the last two games. He was gone up there for, I don't know, 3 or 4 days anyway. But he just loved it though. What a good guy he was. I remember one time I was playing gin rummy with Marv Christensen, and I got into him pretty good. I'm about like $300 ahead of him, and he said, "Let's play one more game, and we're double or nothing." I said, "Okay." I won, so it's $600, and he said, "One more time, double up." And I says, "I don't want to take that much money from you." And Marvin, he says, "That's okay, I get a chance to get even." He said, "I know I'll win it back." And I said, "Okay, if you want to do that." And we played, I don't remember how many points you played to, but I won again, it's $1,200. And he said, "Now let's do it." And I said, nope, that's it. And he said, "You're not going to give me a chance." I said, "I've given you three chances, and you just keep losing more." And I said, that's the last. And he said, "Okay." He's got his checkbook out. And I said, "Make out just one check to me for $600. He said, "I owe you $12. I said, "Okay, make the other one out to Urthel Grant." Urthel was right there in back of the bar. He stayed there. It's 2 o'clock in the morning. He usually leave at midnight. But he would stay until we got through playing. Anyway, so Marv wrote that, and he said, "I'm not going to give that to him." And I said, "Okay." And I grabbed it from him, and I gave it to Urthel. I said, "Here you are, Urthel. Appreciate it. Thanks a lot."
Just staying open.
Yeah. But he was a good guy anyway. You know, the money was free, and so, for me. But
yeah.
Anyway, yeah, good guy.